Hey everyone, this is Dan from DHTV, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to update and install iOS 8 on your iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. Let's get started. So before we get started with the installation, it's always a good practice to save a backup. So what you want to do is plug your iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch up to your computer and save a backup through iTunes or through iCloud. So either way, just make sure you save a backup just in case if something goes wrong, you're protected. Also, before you upgrade, you want to make sure your device is actually supported. So if you own an iPhone, the iPhone 4S, iPhone 5, 5C, 5S, 6, and 6 Plus are all supported. They can be updated to iOS 8. If you own an iPad, the iPad 2, 3, 4, and iPad Air are all supported, as well as the iPad Mini and iPad Mini 2. They're also supported, and you can update to iOS 8. In terms of iPod Touch, the only iPod Touch that can be updated to iOS 8 at this point is the 5th generation iPod Touch. Now, for those of you who own an iPhone 4S, I strongly recommend you think about upgrading carefully, because if you do upgrade to iOS 8, there's no turning back to iOS 7. And what we saw with the iPhone 4s when they upgraded to iOS 7 was a lot of lagging, freezing, things not working right, and eventually a phone that was almost useless at times. So I'm thinking the same thing's going to happen with the iPhone 4s, and I have been reading a lot of things about it, that upgrading to iOS 8 is just a little bit too much for that phone to handle. And of course, it's at that time where Apple is using it as the last device that supports the newest software, so obviously it's not going to run as fast and as smooth, sort of to push you to upgrade to a new device. So if I had an iPhone 4S at this time, I'd stick to iOS 7 until I was ready to upgrade to another device or I had the funds to do so. Once you've backed up your device, what you want to do is go into the settings. You then want to go to general, and then you want to go to software update, and it should bring up this page here. You can click on learn more with all the different features that have been added to iOS 8. Now, one thing to understand is it does say you need 1.9 gigabytes, but unfortunately you have to have 5 gigabytes of space open to actually download iOS 8. I'm not sure why, but that's just how it works. I had to delete a lot of apps and things like that. So go ahead and tap download and install if everything's okay. Enter in your password, if you have one, and it'll begin the installation process. So now we'll just go ahead, scroll down and tap agree. We'll tap agree again, and it's gonna go ahead and run. So if everything ran smoothly, you should have iOS 8 installed. It took me about 45 minutes for the whole process, so hopefully it doesn't take that long for you. If it does, just wait. If anything happens in between, then let me know in the comments. So we'll just go into the settings here. We'll go to general and the about section. And you can see right here we are using version 8.0, so it's updated now to iOS 8, and that's pretty much how you do it the easy way. Now, if you do run into a situation where your iPhone just keeps on failing with that install, go ahead and plug it up to your computer, and on screen, open up iTunes and go to the summary section here, and it should bring up a page like this. And what you want to do is either check for updates or update, because there will be an update button here if you're not updated. If I check right now, it does say I'm updated to iOS 8 because everything worked smoothly. But if it doesn't, click that, follow the on-screen steps, or even click restore, and it'll bring up a few of these little boxes, and you can go through it and do a clean install of iOS 8. Make sure that you save a backup though, just in case anything goes wrong, and that way you can restore from your backup when you're done. So that's how you install iOS 8 on the iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. If you have any questions or run into any troubles, leave them in the comment box down below. Also, if you have any error numbers that come up, let me know in the comments down below. I can find out how to help you and fix your problem, get you updated to iOS 8. So if you found this video helpful, hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this one, and I will see you in the next one.